What's up, guys? Welcome to Daily Dose of Reddit. This is your host, Zach, and today's subreddit is r/entitledparents.
This story is called Entitled Brat Broke My Watch and Stabbed My Finger, and Entitled Mother Said It Was My Fault That I Got Stabbed. I am not a full-time Redditor, but I was told by one of my Redditor friends that I can share my story here. Sorry, it's a rather boring story, so I don't know if you guys would enjoy, but here it is. I am 19, an engineering student, freshman, here in my country, Bangladesh. Getting enrolled in a public university is huge. People will literally worship you if you get yourself into a public university. Even parents are willing to pay loads of cash just to get a public uni student as their home tutor. I don't really want to teach kids, as I'm not very good with kids. I can't interact with them so well, but since childhood, I was kind of freedom-loving, like I didn't want my parents to buy me expensive items. I wanted to buy them all by myself with my own earnings. My mother liked it so much and even encouraged me. Since I was 15, I had been saving money to buy a phone. My mom used to add some money in my savings without letting me know. She knew letting me know would kill my inspiration. I knew all this as my dad told me when I was in college and I had an argument with her, and was absolutely my fault. And my dad wanted me to apologize to her, which I did. Sorry if the story is getting long. So during freshman year, I had to upgrade my computer and I wanted to do it with my own earnings. So I thought teaching someone would be a good way to earn some cash again. As I said, I am not into teaching kids, especially not under 14, as they are hard to deal with for me. My mom somehow arranged a tuition for me and it was a 7th grader, 14. But hey, they were ready to give me almost $200, which was nice. So I took the opportunity. And here we go. The horror was waiting for me fully dressed up. It was October when I went there for the first time. Their house wasn't very far from mine, most likely 200 to 300 meters. So the lady, I will call her Entitled Mother, as this subreddit prefers, and the kid, Entitled Brat. So my first conversation with Entitled Mother went like this.
So are you the tutor?
Yep.
You can teach, right?
I will try my best.
Look, not everyone can teach, my honey, Entitled Brat. If you can't teach him, you should let me know right away. We don't have time to waste.
Don't worry, I'll let you know. By the way, can I meet him? Entitled Brat.
He's busy, playing games. You know, kids, right?
Yeah, sure. But a small conversation with him would be good. I have to know him if I'm gonna teach him.
Entitled Brat!
Mom, I can't come now!
Shouting from his room. So she took me into his room to meet with him.
Hey, Entitled Brat. He completely denied my existence.
Mom, I don't have time to meet any random stranger now. I'm playing games.
He's your new home teacher.
Tell him to come tomorrow.
You heard the boy. You can start from tomorrow.
Now, after that awkward conversation, I was getting red flags that this wasn't the right place to teach, as it was my first conversation with this family, so I ignored her ego and kids' misbehavior and tried to stay as polite as possible. But that lady had some serious ego issues. But I decided to teach that brat anyway. Little did I know what was waiting for me. So the next day, I went there. Entitled Mother told me to sit there, so I did. I was waiting for that entitled brat. God, 1 hour went by and no sign of that kid. Also, I was getting annoyed, but after waiting 1 hour 5 minutes, Entitled Mother came dragging Entitled Brat with her and forced him to sit with me so I could teach him, which I tried. Oh boy, I tried. This kid was still ignoring my existence and was drawing on his book. Teaching isn't an easy process. After 2 hours of trying to at least put some data in his head, I failed miserably and went home. He was acting the same for several days. By this, I was getting annoyed. Like, how can I teach someone who didn't have any intention to be taught? Now, so far, I had been teaching this kid, well, at least trying to teach this kid for like 14 days, and I highly doubt he had learned a single word. So I had this watch, which I loved very much. My friend gave it to me as a gift.
On our last day of college, we, the friends, gave each other gifts to remember each other as we were going our own ways. While I was teaching and he was drawing on the wall, he noticed my watch. He tried to snatch it. Again, he's a kid, so I gave him the watch. I thought giving him the watch would make him a little more sincere, but no. Big mistake part one. The moment I gave him my watch, he slapped it against the floor. It got shattered. Entitled mother came running, hearing the noise.
Oh my god, honey, don't move, you will get hurt. Mom, he tried to beat me. What do you think you're doing?
That was my watch.
So?
He broke it.
You are teaching a kid, how dare you wear a watch? Look, if you try to hurt my honey by any means, you will regret it.
Now, at this moment, I completely lost my will to teach that kid. I was angry. I could feel my anger inside, raging. I just walked out from that house, made up my mind, screw money, I am not going there anymore. Went home. I had that watch for like 4 months only. I was kinda sad for a few days. Like 3 to 4 days went by. I didn't go there. Here came the call.
Hello? Where the heck are you?
Sorry, I'm not coming there.
What do you mean?
That I won't teach your kid anymore?
How dare you? We pay you. I demand you come now.
Sorry, keep your money. I don't want to teach your kid.
What? He has exams coming up.
Sorry, I can't help. You better hire another teacher.
I knew it. You didn't want to see my honey pass the exams.
Ma'am, I tried my best to teach your son. Entitled mother was screaming at this point. I couldn't even hear a word she was saying. I hung up. She called my mom, crying, told her that I misbehaved, that her son was gonna fail because of me, that I should take responsibility. My mother, being good as always, forced me to teach that devil kid until exams were over. I thought to give it another chance. Big mistake part two. So I went there on exam night. I was trying, actually dying, teaching that kid. I was putting my soul in just to teach him a match. The kid used to shout whenever I would say, "This math is very important. It's gonna be in your exam." Whenever I said something like this, he used to shout,
"Mom, bring my phone!"
Or,
"Mom, I'm hungry!"
Or,
"Mom, I'm bored!"
He did the same thing that day as well. He also shouted,
"Mom, I'm hungry!"
The maid came, brought some food and a knife. As I was begging this kid to do at least 3 math problems, he was cutting the fruit and throwing them at my face. I had enough. I tried to take the fruit and the knives away from his hand. He then grabbed the knife and stabbed the middle finger of my right hand. I was bleeding. Blood was dripping on their white sofa, which I was sitting on. The kid started screaming as if I stabbed him.
"Mom! Mom!"
Entitled mother came running.
"God, what happened? He tried to stab me! Get away from there! My sofa's getting dirty!"
Their sofa was white, by the way.
"Get out of my house! Don't let my son see blood!"
I've never seen such live-action drama in my entire life. I had my hand stabbed, and this lady was worried that her sofa would get dirty. I was kicked outside. It took some time for my brain to process what had just happened. I was still bleeding. The cut was deep. I could see my bone, and it was also hurting. As my home was nearer than the closest hospital, I rushed home to apply some first aid. My mom opened the door and screamed. When she asked, I told everything, and I was a bit annoyed with my mom, thinking it was her fault pushing me to teach that kid. We went to the hospital right away. Doctors said it wasn't critical, but my bones were fractured and it would take some time to heal completely. All this was happening, so I didn't get the chance to look at my mom's face, but when I did, boy oh boy, I knew exactly what was coming. She was a raging fireball. She went there the next morning. I went with her just in case she didn't do something serious. But I knew I was up for a show. She knocked at their door. Entitled mother opened the door. Mom went inside, pushing her aside.
"Excuse me?"
Mom pointing her finger towards my hand, which was bandaged by the way.
"What is this? It's your son's fault. Your son stabbed my son's hand, and you didn't even offer him first aid. My son is afraid of blood, and your son tried to beat him.
You are not allowed to be a mother. You are not even allowed to be a human.
How dare you? You are in my house. I will get you arrested."
Mom slapped her across across the face. They had a huge TV, which they bought while I was a tutor there. Mom walked towards it, unplugged it from the wall, and we let it kiss the ground. It shattered. Then Mom said to entitled mother,
"That's for my son's watch. Get me arrested."
That was the coolest moment of that day. We went home afterwards. Entitled mother didn't say a single word after that slap. I told my mom how she was so cool and laughed at everything. My mom knew exactly how much I loved that watch. Mom, if you're reading this, I love you more than that watch. They filed a case against us, which we ended up winning. Thank goodness my uncle is a lawyer. They lost quite a lot of cash in court fees and other charges. That is a child that requires lots and lots of discipline, because I can and will say this, that was not very zen of him, or them, I guess. Entitled mother demands my toddler give up his toys because her husband might be a higher rank than mine. It's snowing where I live a lot more than what we're used to getting. We live in a military town. The schools and most other businesses follow the base's lead when it comes to weather-related closures. The base is essential personnel only right now, so I got the day off. I live across the street from the base housing. My husband and I decided to buy our own house instead of living there, but we're still close enough to utilize their parks. Now to the story. The base housing has a little park every block or less. Honestly, a ridiculous amount of parks. We normally just go to the one closest to our house, but since it has been snowing, we decided to go to one further away because it has better hills. My oldest, 4, was bundled up tight and using his sled down the hill, then hiking back up. At one point in time, he got distracted and left the sled, at which point another child jumped on it and was playing with it. That's fine. My son decided he wanted to hike back up and wanted to get his sled. Now, it's important to know that I'm wearing my youngest, a 3-month-old, and because of that, it is unsafe for me to go down the hill in case I fall. I couldn't hear what my oldest was saying to the other child, but eventually he got his sled back and was dragging it up the hill. Enter entitled mom. My son is up the hill now and walking towards me to push him down when he is stopped by entitled mother. Entitled mother reaches for the sled and my son very audibly says,
"No, I used my words."
We're teaching him to use his words instead of hitting when he is frustrated. Entitled mother reaches for the sled as I'm walking up. "Excuse me, can I help you?"
"Is this your child?"
"Yes, he is. Again, can I help you?"
"Your child stole this from mine. I watched him."
"That is his sled. I bought it in Popular Town last Christmas. Your child was playing with it for a while, then mine wanted it back."
"No, my child was playing with the sled and yours took it."
"I watched everything that happened. Yes, your child was playing with my son's sled. Then my son used his words and took it back."
"I've never seen you before. Are you even supposed to be here? You know this park is restricted, right? This is military only."
"I'm well within my rights to utilize this park." I grab my son with a sled and go to walk away. But that would be too easy, right? Entitled mother grabs a sled from my son's hand and turns around. "Excuse me, Bench? Do not take things from my child. Who do you think you are?"
"What did you just say to me?"
"Give him the sled back. I'm not playing right now."
"Do you even know who I am? My husband is..."
Insert rank.
"You can't speak to me that way."
"Congratulations. Your husband's rank has absolutely nothing to do with you stealing from my child." I yanked the sled back. I picked up my toddler. Keep in mind, I'm still wearing my youngest, and went to walk away. Entitled mother grabbed for the sled again, causing me to lose my footing. Thank God I didn't fall, because I probably would have had her head. "Look, you freaking twat. Your husband has nothing to do with my husband's career, but your actions have everything to do with his. Keep your crap up and I will get the military police involved. Touch me, either of my children, or the sled again and I will put you on your ass. I'm not playing this game anymore. What you just did put both of my children in danger. Walk the hell away."
"You're threatening me and cussing in front of my child? Who do you think you are? I will report this. I've never even seen you here before. You don't belong here."
"You've never seen me because I work for a living. I don't give a crap about what your kid hears. I'm walking away. Touch me again and I will not hesitate to hurt you. Entitled Mother was yelling more as I walked away, then proceeded to glare at us until my son got cold and we went to walk back. I've heard of these types of people, but I cannot believe I encountered one in the wild. I've dealt with my fair share of entitled parents, but trying to steal from a 4-year-old? Endangering a 3-month-old? That's a new low for me. There's not much required to say regarding the behavior of that mother other than that she's entitled. And, she needs to teach her child how to ask for things. However, the OP's child here did a great job using his words, and he needs to be praised for that. No, but seriously, the kid obviously had an aggression problem before, and they taught him to use his words instead, and he did. And that's just, I don't know, that makes me really happy. That's true. Good job, little kid.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to never miss an episode.